Russ, not sure where to start with that one. What do you make of it?
I'm really proud of the players. I thought for the first 50, 55 minutes, I thought they were brilliant. So brave. Caused all sorts of problems for Bournemouth in the first half in particular. They had moments in the first half. You expect that with the squad they have, the amount of money they've spent in the squad, the experience they have at this level, the athleticism they have. But yeah, nothing but praise for the players for how they were. Get the third goal. They make some changes to the way they were doing things, to the personnel. Ben Cabango coming off his massive moment for us. We have probably the smallest back three or four playing against the biggest front three players, 6'4". It makes it really difficult when we take our most dominant player out aerially. And then some key moments, really. The ball should just get paid back to Fish and he can deal with it, but we don't. We dally on it a little bit. They end up with a corner and they score. Too much height, power, athleticism for what we had on the pitch at that minute in time. The penalty is a tough one to take. And then Keith Moore should get sent off in the 73rd minute. Like, I don't like moaning about referee decisions, but he's elbowed Flynn and anyone who watches the highlight. No, it's not not me being sour grapes and all that stuff, because Bournemouth were good. They threw absolutely everything at it. Just risked it all, really. And we didn't quite have the quality really difficult to turn the momentum when we don't have a chance to press because they hit it long to the guys at the front. They feed off second ball, so we got caught in between a little bit. And when we did have the chance to play, it was just not, the detail wasn't quite there. But we have some great moments. Mikey is in 1v1 in the box and slips, and then they go and get a penalty at the other end and score. So, and then the third goal is a push on Flynn. Like, again, this is just clear decisions, really. Really tough for referees. I'm not coming out and saying that's the reason. We should win the game at 3-0 up, of course, but it's a different feeling to Reading. It's not a mentality problem. That was we're playing against a team who are where they are in the league, fighting for everything and risked everything to do it. And if we'd had a little bit more composure in some moments, we maybe might have stolen it. There was opportunities to counter-attack and steal a fourth goal. But yeah, I've got nothing but pride. This is very different to Reading when we maybe questioned a bit of mentality. Very, very different.
Yeah, because I think people will see 3-goal lead goes again, and that's what people will say. How can that happen twice in, 8 days? But you don't see it as the same scenario, clearly.
No, I disagree completely. We, as I said, we have our one player over 6 foot in the back, three or four, whatever you want to call it, comes off the pitch. That's something we need to highlight moving ahead of next season. So there's not going to be many teams who possess the height and power that Bournemouth did at the end. And they went really direct and were really good at it. It's been a big moment for us, Ben coming off, I think.
Is that all from the Jamal Lowe tackle in the first half?
Yeah.
What was the matter with him? Ankle?
Yeah, he just rolled his ankle. Hopefully he'll be okay. Just stiffened up a bit.
In terms of the goals, Russ, and from clinical once again from Joel Pirro and Cyrus Christie as well, it was just all starting with Andy at the back.
Yeah, brilliant moves. Outstanding. Yeah. I'm so, there's some moments that we'll show them on, and we'll learn from this again tonight how we can manage the game better in the second half for sure. Take the sting out of it a little bit, and turn it into the game we want it to be. Really, not enough passes in the second half, not enough control at all. But I understand why, and they'll understand why after watching it back. We just played a team who just completely threw caution to the wind. They had absolutely nothing to lose. They're fighting to get to the Premier League, right? So on another day, we'd take advantage of that. We just couldn't quite do that today. So, the goals, some of the moments in the first half, the one-touch play, the mentality to play in tight areas, the courage and connection they have to do what we're asking them to do has been incredible. And they've grown so much. I said that to them in there. They're really close. We're really close to being a really, really, really good team at this level. And the Fulham for 40 minutes tonight for 50, 55 minutes, you've seen that. So we just have to keep growing. We have a very young team on the pitch. And a team that we can't go and spend millions and millions and millions of pounds on. So we have to grow what we've got and try and add to it in our own way, and we will do. So as I said to you before, I'm really disappointed for the players, but I'm so proud of them tonight and what we've done. 9 games unbeaten. I don't think at this level it can go. That's not easy. I'm really proud of them for that. And they're really disappointed. They're really disappointed. But some key moments have gone against us, and that's football, that's life. We'll learn from it, and we'll get ready to go again on Saturday to try and show again against a team that's I think only had the only team that's had better form than us in the last, maybe changed after tonight, but in the last 6-10 games or whatever. So look forward to it.
Yeah, and you mentioned in the past about squad depth. You have a couple of key attacking players in Patterson and then Olivier and Chowne.
Yeah, they, if we were able to bring them on or even get them on the bench tonight they weren't quite ready, which we thought Pato was, but he felt it a little bit again yesterday. So that was disappointing. But if we can bring them on when a game like that is, and with their mentality and their experience and their composure, it makes a big, big difference. If you look at their bench compared to ours, I think. So we have two under-18 players who are going to be outstanding players for us, but we have them on the bench, and Corey and Jay, really, you know, the experienced ones that we had on there. So, yeah, it's as I said to you all the way along, we know where we need to strengthen, we know how we need to strengthen, but I'm so proud of how much they've grown and where they've come. From where we were to where we are now is a big, big difference.
Especially Russell, you mentioned Kiefer Moore's elbow. Did you think that was careless or something more sinister?
I don't know. You'd have to speak to Kiefer Moore. I don't know. I don't know him. I don't know his personality. I wouldn't suggest it was sinister. I'd probably careless, but he really catches him. Yeah, and if it's maybe another player instead of Flynn, it's made. They make a bit more of it. But if you watch it, you make up your own mind, but it's sending off.
He's had issues at international level with Wales, as we've picked up many times. Mm-hmm. Russell, did you sort of think it's the way he jumps?
Yeah, it's not a jump. He's fighting with Flynn and trying to hold him, and he swings his elbow and it catches him. So, again, this is not sour grapes. This is, if you watch it, I think you make your own mind up.
He needs to be more careful.
Yeah, I don't know him. I don't watch him relentlessly. I don't. So, I'm more worried about our player. I'm not going to get in a discussion about Kiefer Moore and what he needs to do better and what he doesn't. I've never worked with him. Yeah.
Russ, you came in this year without a pre-season. You came in and posed a different style on the team. You mentioned just then that you're satisfied with how much the group has grown, how far it's come. Are you confident with a full pre-season this time around that you can hang on to key players, you can challenge?
I don't want to talk about challenging stuff yet, but I'm confident we'll be better than we are now. So I think it was all about convincing people that, A, we could do something in a certain way and try and bring a style and a way of doing things back here. Culturally, playing style, how the players behave, and they've grown a huge amount as men, young men, and off the pitch, and it's been really great to see. So I think the players really believe. I think the fans have been incredible with their patience and support for what we're doing. Hopefully they can see the progression. There has been a huge progression throughout the season. And a full pre-season will just mean that we have a chance to actually start the season well. We're paying for a really slow start, which I knew would happen coming in 4 games as well. I was really honest about that, because it does take time. But if you can see the courage they're showing now, they don't display that without really believing in it and believing in each other. So that's the hardest part. And the next bit is to make sure that we keep solving problems that we find, and find players that will help us grow and improve.
Well, good. Thanks, Russ.
Cheers.